ako sa career ko din eh, I really follow like systems and methods, parang ganun. And then if I have proven that one, and then inuulit ko siya eh. Inuulit ko siya to a certain like degree sa campaign, sa business ng clients ko, etc. So I'm really interested what are we going to dive deep later on. So Jonathan, so since you're a certified life coach or professional coach right now, ang isa bang life coach, nawawalan din ba ng motivation? How do you bounce back? Anong ginagawa mo? Could you give us some tips then?
I just thought of it now. Actually, hindi ko naisip yun na, nga pala wala akong boss. It was really out of my mind. I was more like, okay, there's a set of things that I should do. And I have a vision. But when I have clients or what I call coaches, na napapansin ko there's a certain strength in willpower nila. Na napapansin ko malakas yung loob, matapang. I ask them this question. What would your future self tell you right now? So what I do is I sort of create a boss, but the boss is also themselves, but the future version. Kasi makikinig sila dun eh. Kasi that's okay. The future. Minsan mahirap if you're listening to yourself who's also immersed in the very same problem that you have. So sabi ko, hindi. Imagine a version of yourself na natapos na lahat ng to. What would he tell you? What would she tell you? Second is, so how do I overcome it? Number one, meron akong ginagamit na simple framework at what we call well-being areas. So ako, I use yung simple lang, yung four, which ang composition niya is physical well-being, mental well-being, emotional well-being, and spiritual well-being. So pag nagkulang ako sa motivation, first I ask myself on those four. Sabi ko, how is my well-being in those four aspects? For example, physical. Pag sa physical, it involves your physical health and physical environment. Am I eating right? Am I sleeping correctly? Is my room in the right temperature? Mainit ba? So parang ganon, the physical state muna. It's like...
Parang environment. Pwede din yeah,
yeah. 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 It's like the environment plus you physically. Kasi... It's hard to be productive kung nakapatay yung ilaw, tapos malamig, hindi ka pa kumakain. Talagang early, tamarin ka talaga. So yun yung first thing. Second thing is the mental and emotional state. So pag sabing mental, do you have a certain bias? Is there a toleration going on? Are you, yung thought process mo ba, stuck na siya? Nakaklog ka na ba along the way? So that's mental. And emotional state is, are you happy? How are you managing? Or how are you feeling? Are you sad, happy, angry, or afraid? So parang it's very important to know kasi we decide differently depending on how we feel. People decide, iba yung personality traits nangunguna when they're deciding in the state of comfort. Decide differently when in the state of stress. And yung pinaka-last, they decide really differently. Crisis naman, yan yung crunch time na tayo na we need to decide. So spiritual is more on sense of purpose, identity, self-awareness. What am I doing for? One question that I think people often forget is people are clear of the goal, but they're not clear of what they're gonna lose. If I don't do this, what am I gonna lose? Kasi importante yan eh. It has to go two way. It's like, why am I doing this job? Because if I don't do this job, I'm gonna not be able to pay my bills, maghihirap ako and all. And it has to be very clear that there's something to lose for you. Kaya very effective yung what we call deadlines eh. Di ba? When you have a deadline, napapansin mo, yung motivation mo at sipag mo habang papalapit yung deadline, parami ng palakas ng palakas. Mm-hmm. It's because the deadline is now becoming really, really painful. Naramdam mo na what you're gonna lose after this.
Imminent na eh, nandun na.
Yeah, imminent na. I think you can go for the listeners, they can Google. It's called Parkinson's Law.
Yeah,
it's Parkinson's Law. Pag papalapit ka ng palapit sa deadline, the urgency just really builds. Mm-hmm. Gagawa mo na yun.
We also use that in marketing eh. Like you put on a deadline, diba?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like 24 hours. You can grab this price at this. Parang ganun. Yeah.
Yeah. Then lastly, to wrap this up, very important is there has to be a person to check on your progress, to check on you. Because ang mahirap, alam mo yung sinasabi mo na, okay lang ako, I'm doing great, everything's fine, but you're in a blind spot. You're comforting yourself that it's good, it's going to be great. Not until someone without the bias, with the same interests that you have, will really see na there's some points that you're missing out. In fact, meron na ako isang napanood na video by a doctor, surgeon siya, plenty of years in the practice. One day he felt like hindi na siya nag-grow. So he decided to get his old professor to watch him do a surgery. His name is Dr. Atul Gawandi. Then akala niya after the surgery, okay, I did great. But after the surgery, his old mentor, doctor professor, came to him na, just very minor things. However, the minor things na kailangan adjust was like sobrang kapal. Ang daming na-take note ng doctor that you've missed out. And they replicated the same study over a set of medical hospitals in India. How does a third person, a person who's watching, who's trying to check on your progress, really affect result? And they were able to plot it out.
That person could be like for us, like as freelancers, tayo, mga self-employed people. So who could that person be? That could be a mentor or just accountability, mga ganon.
Wala naman actually yung concrete rule. However, ang kailangan lang into account is the trust. And one is the trust, how honest you can go. Kasi kasi the problem is, may accountability partner ka, pero hindi mo naman kaya maging honest.
Yeah.
So mahirap yun. You're still going to go back in the same blind spot. You need to have that trust and honesty na masabi mo lahat. And sunod is, how sure are you that the person will be unbiased of their own interests, of their own preferences?
I must agree with that one. Yung sabi mo yung another eye to check on you. Kasi like ako sometimes I just ask, like I have this friend na tinatrust ko talaga. And I think naman, unbiased naman yung mga, we're honest to each other. Like we say like, alam niya yung sinasabi niya yung mga bad things about each other. Like ganun. So, tinanong ko siya before, I was in this like parang down, parang low siya ng career ko before. So sabi ko, ano mong problema ko? I feel so used and abused ng mga tao. Parang ganun. So sinabi niya sa akin, you know what? I think ang problem mo kasi you're just being too nice. Sabi ko, what do you mean? So parang inisa-isa namin yung parang scenario. So sinabi niya talaga sa akin, nag-iayos ko talaga na tama siya. And then from then on, tinanggal ko yung mga ganung characters ko. Ang laki ng tulong niya talaga.